Welcome back to Good Day Atlanta. Youth sports have so many benefits to children. That is, if parents don't ruin it for them. The Fox 5 I-Team's Dana Fowle is here. And Dana, you spoke with a coach that started with one of the Women's World Cup players back in the early days. What does he say about this?
You know, he says, get out of the way. Mm-hmm. Get out. And you, we'll ask you about this, too. Get out of the way. Let the kids love the sport on their own. Listen, as we've talked about already, three players on the U.S. Women's World Cup team are from Georgia. That's remarkable. It takes natural skill, natural drive, but also a lot of hard work. And parents paying the tab, parents toting them around when they're younger. But how much is too much? Let's start with this video we saw about a week ago. Remember this? Parents brawling at a kid's baseball game over calls, I might add, made by a 13-year-old umpire. It's sad. It's ridiculous. But sadly, it's not a rare sight at all anymore. I have a kid athlete. I bet some of you do. Maybe you've got a great chess player. Whatever it is, how can you be supportive yet stay out of the way? It's tough. I get it. I talked with Coach Ward Swain of NASA Top Hat. It's a Marietta club where he helped coach U.S. defender Emily Sonnet. It's one of the best clubs in the country. It's competitive. He says this is what you do after a game, a good game or a bad game. Same advice. Say, hey, I enjoyed watching you play. Did you have fun? What do you want for lunch? Then just zip it.
The thing is, the parents who really get it understand it's their daughter's adventure and not their adventure. They happen to be along for the ride. Yeah. If the parents are trying to drive the whole thing the whole time, the kid's probably not going to have fun because they feel like they're playing not for the joy of playing and the joy of hanging out with their friends, but because they feel like they have to make their parents proud.
Now to coach and Emily Sonnet, that's rare. He said, in fact, her whole team as a kid was amazing. It could have been any one of them. But a lot happens, obviously, between 9 and 21, right? So he said, listen, if I coach a cool kid and she quits at 13 and I run into her at the grocery store and she's still a great kid, that's a success story. On the field, he teaches them to play soccer. Off the field are the real lessons for many, analyzing and rebounding from mistakes, managing failure, learning how to give your best effort no matter the outcome. Mm-hmm.
They have to have fun, so sometimes it's good for the parents just to stay out of the way, just make sure they have the essentials, right?
Yeah.
Now, getting back to the parents, how many parents does he deal with, like in that video?
That extreme, probably not many, but he says they're usually divided into three groups, the hands-off type, the overly involved, and some are in between. But here's his advice to coaches. Embrace the parents. Don't treat them as the enemy. Let them know what's going on. Communicate with them too. Explain why you're working on certain skills, and that'll help them along the way as well.
Very important lessons there. Well, now it's on to Paris. The U.S. Women's National Team arrived.